Yeah. Did you get the San Diego Smooth Dancers newsletter? Do you get that?
Yes.
Yes, we do.
Do you see your thing up for you guys?
Oh, no, we didn't see that yet because it gets forwarded to us.
Yeah, it gets forwarded to us.
I should forward it to you.
Okay. Well, what did they say about us?
Oh, it just showed it had a nice picture of you and the coronation. Oh, okay. And actually, it had some pictures of Mike and I, and Mike wrote a little thing about dancing in it, too. Wow. Yeah. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, well. And then I think the Dance Whispers of coming out. And
yeah.
I got to send an article. It'll have my article, but it'll be in January before that's out, I think.
Got it.
Because this was the coronation, wasn't it, issue? Or no? Our Dance Whispers was the coronation.
Oh.
Of, I mean, the convention.
Oh, yeah, the last one that came out, you're saying? Yeah.
The next thing is whatever.
Yeah. This was the San Diego newsletter, but you get that usually
too.
Somebody forwards it.
It might not happen as soon as you get it, but we'll get it.
Yeah, I can. If I think of it, I'll forward it to you.
So we just were reviewing the videos.
Okay.
What struck me, in the promenade, is that at least, first of all, I tend to lift my feet up too much, and then secondly, we seem to bounce. You know. Stomping and bouncing down there, whereas when I do with you, then it's smoother, you know.
No bouncing.
You know, so.
It's like dancing with a book on your head.
Yeah. So you gotta get rid of the bounce. We gotta learn, like, I noticed when you're explaining it, you gotta go heel, right? And then you start out with a toe, right? Toe.
Well, actually, you start out, your first step would be.
Oh, heel.
Yeah.
It's always the heel lead, right? Heel. And then heel, right, to keep the heels dragging is hard. Because you should either have a toe or heel always on the floor, right?
Yeah, ideally you have some part of your foot in contact, whether it's the tip of the toe, the ball of the foot, the heel, some part is.
We both are picking up our feet too much.
Right.
And then with you too, you're taking bolder steps, and then the swinging together at the end of that part.
Right.
You gotta work on that because it looks so much smoother if you can propel you with it.
Yeah.
Motion to it, you know.
And when you're doing that, it's still making that smooth, so it's not.
Right.
So what makes us go up and down? Is it because we aren't bending our knees and keeping them bent? Are we not doing?
You know, I think a lot of it is just the awareness, is that hasn't been part of your awareness before. Right. Now, it's bringing that into your awareness.
But I think if you keep your feet on the ground, you're going to bounce less. Yeah. Just by nature, you're stepping.
Right. Lifting up and placing. So when people first start Foxtrot, if I'll do like a little demonstration, they're like.
Right.
And they're kind of feeling the beat as they're taking the step like that, right?
Yeah,
and kind
of. A lot of people in our club that dance like that.
Yeah.
You see them, you know, in the bounce.
Right, because they're, you know, and that's kind of feeling the beat and expressing the timing, but not understanding how to, make it nice and smooth.
Some people seem to be proud of the fact that they're there when they're dancing to them.
Really,
wow, look at me, I'm really with the music, you know?
Right, and you know what? For social dancing, as long as you're having fun, but it's for you guys. It's also like a hobby dancing too, and to be able to see some improvement, you know, it makes it worthwhile to keep doing it too, right? It gives you that motivation, like when you did your performance, right? Yeah, it gave you motivation to, to keep delving into it. So you're right about keeping contact on the floor, because if you notice when I'm doing that, I'm lifting. And you know, it's interesting because usually when we walk pretty smooth in most cases, but when we start dancing,
something happens.
But see, what you're doing right now, don't you think that looks a lot smoother?
It does.
And I can see, can you see how close his feet are to the floor now? And compare it, if you can.
I was trying to polish the floor.
I always say, like, a lot of times dancers, when you're out on, we're used to this nice smooth floor and you're out on the regular sidewalks and stuff, you trip over things because you're so used to keeping contact and keeping that awareness of the floor.
But in doing this, you're not really necessarily exaggerating the toe lift or anything, right? Yes.
When you take your heel lead?
Yeah.
Like exaggerating, like how far do I...
You go up together, then you use a lot of toes, right? Side together.
Uh-huh. Like pushing from the toes.
Yeah.
Yeah. But do you see, it's still pretty calm if I do.
Right.
And the other thing that I just started doing too is adding
more of this. The shoulders
yes.
and everything.
Yeah.
Right.
So the more of that you have, the more you can keep this all the frame very calm as you're doing the rest. If I'm doing stuff where this is moving around, that really makes the whole thing.
The other part was the frame where she has to stay behind here.
Yep.
And my arm tends to kind of want to go like
this. Yes, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So to keep my arm more out this way.
Mm-hmm.
And then that keep this in between, right?
Mm-hmm. Right.
And then, so ready.
Yeah.
Your head gets stuck to the nail.
Yeah. I'll try one more time.
Yeah.
And that was much better. There's still a few things. There's always like that next layer of things that you can keep working on, you know, now that you got that.
Because I would have thought, oh, we know how to promenade. You know, what is there to learn?
Yeah.
Even on a very simplistic beginner's level, and then you understand.
Right. But you know what? The better that you get these basic movements,
right.
when you move into the higher level, more difficult patterns, you know, then they're going to be smoother, right? Mm-hmm. And you've probably seen people that do difficult patterns that aren't that smooth at it, you know? And so, so getting the basics so you don't have to come back and change. Once you get used to doing something a certain way, it's really hard to break that habit.
Yeah.
So getting good habits right from the beginning,
You know, like Saturday and Sunday, we came to two dances here.
Oh, wow, great.
Well, Saturday was the Dance Essence dance, and Sunday was our club dance.
Oh, yeah, it was here.
Yeah, it was
That's
here.
Right, it was here. I remember you saying that.
The Foxtrot mixers, I always dread doing it because I know I'm going to screw it up. And so once I did it once, and I did it with her. I was sitting down, I wasn't doing it. She finally didn't have a partner. What's that? I screwed it up too. I don't know why. It's not that hard, but so then we'd end up doing just the basics, you know, the basic and the promenade, basic and promenade.
Yeah, that's fine.
But then every time we tried, then we tried to do the passes and everything.
He tries to do the waltz things in the Foxtrot, which is not, we don't really know how to do that. We've just
tried
to do
it. Well, yeah, you just change the timing, but anyhow, whatever.
Right. But I think that, you know, we went back to the very basic and then that's kind of out here. And so, you know, connecting that back together. So
I'd like to be able to do at least five different steps reliably with great confidence and halfway decently, you know.
Okay.
Because if I only can do like three steps, I don't want to dance because I get totally bored.
Right.
You know?
Right.
I can, like you said, you want to do a tango? Yeah, we'll do 1 minute. Because we don't know enough steps, and after 1 minute, I'm done.
I could do the same step all for the whole darned song.
Yeah.
It doesn't bother you.
Yeah.
So.
Well, when you're leading, so you're kind of in charge. You say, I got to sing that verse again. I think we should need a few more verses, you know what I mean?
Yeah, right. Yeah. And I think it is kind of as the man creating it, right?
Yes.
It's like, okay, what do I create next?
Yeah,
you know,
what am
I got to build something new. Right. Okay, so let's do the promenade one more time because that's definitely getting better and better each time. Much better. Okay, so let me do a couple of things. You know what, I really like all that collection where it's brushing through, it just like your footwork is just much
and
more clean.
She's not stepping back anymore because that was the problem.
Right.
Right.
And
she's doing
okay
now because...
Yeah, I'm going to do one little tip for each one of you on this because we kind of just keep adding one little thing. So if I start with you first, Linda, so you're doing really good, you know, brushing your feet through and really good stepping across that line. But what I do notice, one little thing is that when you bring your feet together, your left heel stays up. And it, yeah, so when I settle into that foot, so that when I start the next movement, do you see how everything's kind of engaged now? The hip joint, the knee joint, and the ankle joint. But if I stay up on my toe, and you were actually doing a good job, like it didn't seem to make you falter, but it could, as you start adding other things in, lead to like losing your balance a little bit. Okay. So when you come through here, make sure that you settle that left heel. Yeah, so my right heel can be, as my left heel settling down, my right heel can be slightly off, and then it starts to make contact if I was going to do another promenade. But I could also then be ready to go backwards if that's what he wants to do next too. Okay. But if I stop myself here on the toe, you still made it to the promenade and you did a good job, but it could, as you get into other things, it's just, again, a habit that... Yeah, so just that one little piece, bringing that to your awareness of just making sure that your left heel drops down.
Okay.
And then for you, on your second step, so you're coming through here, and it seemed like when I saw you do it by yourself, you did a good job, like it comes out next to my standing foot, next to my left, then it moves across a little bit, just as I take the step. But let's see, what I saw you do, what, there was something right as you were taking this step.
I guess I'm trying to keep it on a line, so I'm not supposed to step across like this and then kind of keep my feet kind of
So maybe you were going across yourself a little bit too much.
But should the goal be, if my feet are on this piece of wood, the next step should be done this way?
Yeah, it's not going to go quite that.
Yeah, that's exactly what I'm about, but I shouldn't
so
try to do that.
So I would say, do you see how about...
Slightly forward.
Then. Yeah, so see, it's pretty close to the toes.
Yeah.
And do you see how I want to be careful not to turn it in here?
Okay.
But I think you're going a little bit too far across yourself. And
so like your training foot, the heel has to cross this toe.
So you just
kind of keep it going that way then.
Yeah, when this one comes in, your right one, it comes in and it kind of matches this one for that split second. Then it comes out in front of it.
Uh-huh.
Then it goes across.
Mm-hmm.
It goes across, if you notice, as it goes, it starts across here, but it continues across when this heel of the left foot, do you see, goes up?
Mm-hmm.
So my left heel goes up before my right heel commits to that spot. Can you see this back heel? And then I land, as opposed to landing here, why this foot is still flat, why my left foot is still flat on the floor. So I have to make sure that, do you see there's that rolling action from foot to foot.
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. So when you step here, there's rolling, roll. Yeah. Uh-huh.
Whoop.
You need to put some back.
I know, it really grabs too.
They
just ordered it. It's on the...
Oh, did you order some of the silicone stuff? Uh-huh.
He doesn't want to put
Vaseline
on. Yeah. I gotta think this through.
Whoop. Yeah, that's the idea of it, for sure. Much better. And even think about that as you go to take the first step. So if my feet were together and I went to take the step with the left foot, you can see I'll start to put the left heel out, but you see my right heel is still on the floor. So now watch, I'm actually not gonna take the step until I roll out of that right heel. Yeah. Instead of, do you see how that leaves me at least part of my weight back behind me? Yeah. So I have release step, release and land. Release. Yeah, and that time on your first step, I could still see it flat. See if you can see me do you see how I'm taking that step, uh-huh. but this heel is still on? So again, it's, if I did it in slow motion.
Like pushing with the right foot, that's better, right?
Yeah, and you know, so if I go like this, I go down into it. So I have to take my, okay, I think that was a good one. Let me see you do that again. Yeah, so I have to take the heel off the floor of the right foot, and what I'm pushing with from the right foot is the ball of the foot, uh-huh. right? So I got to take the heel off to push from the ball of the foot. Right, and that would be another thing that would smooth you out. And just like walking forward, uh-huh. if you did the forward walking basic, and I put this foot out in front, I wouldn't actually commit myself to it until this back heel mm-hmm. comes off. And then do you see how it moves a little bit more? So, yeah. So if I do the two steps forward, I do that same thing. And as I put this foot out, I lost my balance. As I put this foot out in front, again, I'll release that back heel. And that releases my weight from that foot and then allows me to move. So I put the release from the back foot. The back heel comes up, and it allows me to push myself with the ball of the foot. Mm-hmm. And then we have a different action going backwards, which is, you know, makes it a little more difficult mm-hmm. because we can't, the whole idea of pushing from the ball of the foot, you can't do when you back up.
Yeah.
Right? You can only do that. Yeah, because our legs are designed mostly to move forward, right? It's like, too bad the lady's knees don't go the other way. And our feet are turned around. That would be perfect. Okay, so when we go backwards, if I put my foot out behind me, I'm not going to actually start putting weight into that foot until the toe comes off the floor or toes of my forward foot, my left foot. So I will be releasing. It's kind of like rolling and catching. And then collecting that under. I put the foot behind me, but I'm not gonna actually move my body weight onto it until I release the forward toe. And that's the one thing that enables us to roll from foot to foot. You can see if I just go like this back and forth, that I'm rolling through the feet instead of going. Do you see? And that's what, again, makes it choppy, because I'm not letting my feet move me, and then I start doing moving my body in a way to kind of bounce my body onto my... Yes, that's it. Whoa, that's it. And you know, as you practice that, if you can practice keeping your eyes slightly up and keeping the sternum up so it doesn't, And it's definitely more difficult than going forward.
Yes.
Yeah, much better. Mm-hmm.
And it's hard for me to stay balanced all the time. I think maybe I need more, the muscles aren't all as strong as they should be.
Yeah, you know what? That's so true, because you strengthen the muscles by doing the action over and over. And until you've done it, and your feet and your ankles and everything gets stronger, then it's like, whoa. And you know, there'll always be a little bit of a balancing. So if I just barely have a connection with you so that I'm not holding you up. But so you could see, or you could feel when I put my foot out, but I haven't moved yet. You can see how that my foot's out in front of me if you look down for a sec. So your foot will prep by going behind you, mm-hmm. but not so far that it starts to pull you onto it, because you're gonna actually move onto it when you lift the toes from that foot. Uh-huh, and then put your foot behind you, but you're not gonna actually move until your toe Mm-hmm. Yeah, can you feel get a little bit ahead of me there? So now you walk forward this time so that you can feel how I follow your movement. So you walk and I'm going to follow you. Uh-huh. Just keep walking.
You do very well.
Now, turn around one more time,
Okay. Or
one time, and I'm going to be just slightly ahead of you so that when you do that, I'll show you what it feels like if the lady's slightly ahead.
Yeah, you're ahead.
Right, you can tell. And my foot's going down before yours, so if you happen to take a bigger step than me, I've already committed before you. So do it one more time, and I'll follow you again.
That's just easy, like, yeah.
Yeah, so that takes some practice, right? Because I've been doing it for a long time, of being able to time yourself so that, right? Oh, do one more thing, and I want to show you what it feels like to the man. If I don't let the toes come off the floor, because that's the number one thing that's the most difficult thing, I think, for ladies to get in the beginning, because we tend to want to grip, especially because it feels like we're going to fall backwards. Right. The first thing you want to do is grip your toes. So I'm going to keep my toes on the floor this time as you come forward.
Oh, yeah. It's like a brake.
Yeah, right?
Yeah.
I always say it's like having the emergency brake on, right?
Yeah.
So even though I'm trying to move with you, there's something that doesn't just let me flow.
Yeah.
And the toes are like stopping each time. And, you know, just practicing that where I'm rolling back and forth, and you can hold on to something like a counter at home to balance you if you need to, and just getting used to that rolling from foot to foot and the timing that you feel for yourself when you're doing that. And the balance as you do that, making sure that you're eyes are up. And then maybe take one step, two steps, you know, taking a couple of steps at a time. Mm-hmm. Forward and back. And sometimes we go forward too, so we need to practice both directions. Yeah. But you can always have, and it's what we do naturally when we walk. You know, we don't walk with our feet, or most people don't, like, right? You know, we let our feet roll when we walk. We kind of roll through our feet pretty naturally, right? But if I do, like, when people start dancing, do you see how?
Yes.
I stop doing what I naturally do. So part of it is just learning to, what do I naturally do, right? So that's pretty natural to move backwards. This, yeah. And if you feel yourself falling back, it means your body, do you see, if my body gets back too quick, I'm going to be falling backwards. So I have to keep myself poised a little bit forward when I'm going backwards, right? Because you can see if I'm like this, it's going to be hard to stop the body. So another thing is that the more I'm back like this, the smaller my step is because my foot goes down quickly to catch it. But if I'm poised just a little forward, do you see how I have that full swing while I'm standing here? And then I move myself back over it. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. That's making a little bit more of a difference too, isn't it? Yeah, and you know, it's hard to do multiple steps in the beginning, you know, so if you get a couple of steps and you start to fall out of balance, it's maintaining that. And it's also, the last thing is maintaining a certain amount of tone in your body so that you can maintain that balance point from almost like if you were walking with a tightrope stick or something that had something to balance you. So as your arms are out, there's a certain amount of tone in your body and your frame that helps you. Hey, that helps you to stay.
Right.
Yeah. Hi, John.
Hi.
You're early. Yeah.
Yeah, a little bit.
Yeah.
I'm not going to wait here instead of waiting in traffic.
Yeah, definitely.
Oh, she's on time. So this weekend we have San Fernando's.
Oh, that's this weekend. Oh, yeah.
More opportunities to dance.
Yes. More Foxtrot mixers. We got to get this down, right?
Yeah. Crash course here.
Yeah, no, but I think that it looks like much smoother.
Yeah.
So let's put on a little bit of music. You want to do that? So we do a little dancing.
Right.
Actually, I don't think I took my phone over there. Let me do that.
They need a new mini jack there, so then you can plug it into an iPhone with the case on. Because I've got a
I know,
case on.
Right?
You know, they must make some that have a little skinny pointed.
I know they do. Some of the studios have them.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Because we have to put my iPhone there.
Oh, what happened? All the computers gone.
Yeah, they said the computers are broken, I think.
The computers are broken?
Yeah, so they have to use iPhones to get the music.
Ah, good thing I have my iPhone.
So all the set lists are all making it.
So we're doing a routine to the Bolero in our class.
Oh, did you do your routine at the party? Oh, you didn't end up doing it?
No, we're going to do it then. The Thanksgiving
one. Oh, the Thanksgiving one. Oh, got it.
But then we're also doing a group routine for the Bolero. So we asked her.
In the Bolero?
To the Bolero. So we asked her, could you play a Bolero? So she plays Ravel's Bolero. Well, that did not work.
Oh, that's not even a Bolero.
That's not a Bolero. So.
Oh, yeah. Oops, this isn't even on. Because this arm is closer to you, it's like kind of like you're more balanced on that side.
I couldn't regain my balance. I feel like I want this balance.
Can I do just a little bit with each one of you to the music? So yeah, the more you can bring, the more distance you can bring from your spine to your elbow for the lady to stand on this side of you.
Wait till your charms are right for these arms to surround.
See if you can bring that arm out a little bit. There you go. That's it. Changing the hand position was good. And then feel like your head is just a little bit forward. So can you lift up from here? Yeah, there you go. That's it.
It's like driving a Tesla here.
You want to try the promenade? Yeah, so can you feel me kind of using my feet to move me in that? Yeah. Yeah.
Definitely a different sensation. It is really like I got a self-driving car. I just got to keep my hands on the wheel.
Okay, now let me... So do you see how I have... So if this comes in here, you feel that changes our balance?
Yeah.
So, and I feel like the man in promenade, I want him to move out and not like move me out so that being the follower, I can fill in the space behind him, right? So here is if I, do you see how I kind of send you out? Actually sends you out in front of me when I do that. Yeah. So I'm just gonna go, I'm gonna keep a hold of you, but I'm not gonna push at all. Okay. And I'm gonna go, and like, remember how we did that last week where we just held on? And you keep up. So you're moving yourself. And now I feel that you're a little bit forward towards me. So do you see if I come?
Yeah.
Yeah? So let me just stop you for a sec. Yeah, that's it. Now, I don't want you necessarily to have to feel like you lean back. But
okay. Don't lean forward.
Yeah.
Okay.
So just kind of pick this straight up. Yeah, because if you go back, remember that's going to take your weight into your feet too quick. You can feel that kind of push through my feet. So I'm letting you kind of fill in that space behind, That's so much better though. You're following that so much better. Now you can listen to my story. Give the order. Can't we go to get his fever? We can be fair and have some. I'm going to do this towards the mirror ones. Much better, don't you? Yeah. I felt like you followed me much better today than last week, actually, so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I was trying to make sure I put my heel down.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
One thing at a time.
And then in that promenade, you see, I wasn't making you...
Go forward.
I wasn't pulling you along with me because that actually stops me to try to bring you.
Yeah.
So I'm just going in hopes that you'll come along with me, right? And the more that you know how to move yourself, right? Then the more easier that's going to be for you to do that. In the beginning, like most women don't think, they don't really understand how to move themselves and what's our responsibility, what's the man's responsibility, right?
Yeah.
Because you want to be a follower, but what does that mean, right?
Yeah.
And it really just means that he indicates where we're going. So I'm going to indicate we're going to go into promenade, but it's up to you to then, when you get that signal, to take yourself.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, you want to try one time? Yeah, we were really close, huh? Yeah, I thought that was much better.
Yeah, much better.
Yeah. Do you want us to do more, or are you going to come out? You're setting it. Let me put on a little bit different song. I want something that's really easy for you to hear the beat. So maybe this is a little bit slower, but it gives you time to really make sure that you're doing that step brush. Remember to pick your heels up. When you go in promenade, pick up your heel of the back foot so that you're pushing forward from the ball of the foot. Yeah, so you have nice movement across the floor. And Linda, your left elbow is kind of pointing down to the floor. And I noticed when I danced with you a little bit, I could feel a little bit of extra weight. So eventually.
Yeah, we started out good.
Uh-huh. But, and I think, I believe that you already have more range of motion with this side. Because before, it was way down, even lower, right? Like, I feel like as you're using it, it's kind of stretching that out more. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, this feeling of stretching is kind of...
Yeah, so if you let her go for just a second and you put your arms just straight out to the side and stretch like you're going to reach as far as you can. Yeah, so you can see, and that's as high as it goes, right? Oh, okay, good. Okay, so stop it right about there.
Uh-huh,
there you go. And now leaving that there.
You know, we saw on Dancing with the Stars, they got this neck brace thing that goes around and you hang your head.
Yeah.
I need one of those.
I actually let one of my students borrow that, and he passed away, and he had it. And I think his family just got rid of it. I didn't even think of it right away, but I'm like, they probably thought it was like a,
Who
knows,
But they cost like $125.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, I guess I don't need that.
Yeah. Badly. Well, but I guess there isn't one at the studio. Most studios have them, but they are good to get used to feeling that position. Yeah.
Well, the other choice is to buy one of those dancing tuxedos and it holds your arms.
Yep.
I feel like you're stiff here. Is that because you're trying to?
What do you mean by that? Stiffen this side?
I don't know.
But the frame, shouldn't the frame be somewhat rigid?
Let me think. But it feels different than what I'm doing it with you. So on like, this side, you're saying?
Like, this just feels like it feels like I could move you or you don't feel stiff.
Maybe that it's like tight,
like
stiff?
That. Yeah.
Yeah, tight like that?
Like
you. Because I feel like I want to try to keep it so that you could not. Like, I don't want you to move me, right? But I don't want it so stiff that, it's, or tight, I think is what you're saying. So I'm going to have, you don't have to take any steps, but you're just going to stand here in the ladies' position for a second. So I have my arms, but I'm not, I'm not doing it to you, I'm doing it to myself, right? So here, I'm not holding,
I can see the feeling here, it's like really having your armrest.
Right, yeah. Right.
Yeah, whereas I know I don't provide that level
but
of support.
But your range of motion, see I have more range of motion through that arm, so I can, but I, do you see how I go up to meet her arm?
Right, yeah.
And then, so then I try to balance that, my this elbow and this elbow are at the same level. So if you look at me from behind, like a scale, right? So if I'm like this, one's lower, then I'm everything's gonna be kind of tipping in that direction because that's where the lady is, obviously.
Right, right.
So I really wanna have that feeling of it being as level as possible.
Right, okay.
Yeah.
And the shoulder should be back, or?
Yeah, so if you lift your shoulders and push them forward for a second, lift them and pull them down and back. Yeah, so you're using these muscles down here to pull them down, but your elbows are up, but we don't want them so far up that it pushes your shoulders up. Yeah.
Pull my arm up here.
And this, yeah, so here's your elbow at this level. And that's pretty good, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah. And can you relax this at all? Okay. Yeah. So here I feel like I have them at the same level. And you'll see some of those really great international dancers. Yeah. It's like goes straight across right there. Like they have that much range of motion. It looks like
it takes work to hold it in this position.
Yes.
I don't think I could go a whole night of dancing like this.
And can you pull that shoulder down when you step through? So you know the tricky thing is pulling the shoulder down but not letting the elbow come down while you step through with your right foot.
Yeah.
So if you're doing the man's part of the promenade, I think we're probably out of the camera here now. And now you move out in front of me more. Like I feel like you're letting me catch up. There you go. See, I feel like we have the same distance. But I feel like if you step too far across yourself, you can't move as much,
right?
And then I end up catching up to you.
Yeah.
So if it goes like this, you're stopping your own self by stepping across there. Yeah. And again, remember that he's not responsible for moving us. He's just going to go where he's going to go and indicate to us where that is, and we move ourselves.
You're kind of intruding in my
And you know what you're doing so much better today too is getting your feet closed.
Yeah.
So
okay.
I you know, I just realized, oh yeah, that's right, because we worked on that and you're doing it.
See, I'm trying not to step way across, but then I'm hitting her leg.
I think on your second step, so if here's my first step in promenade, I think your second, do you see how I'm turning that hip out? And I think again, it's stopping. So swinging it across this way without over-rotating it.
Over-rotating, okay.
Yeah, so if you're doing, let me just do that with you one time. So you're here, now, right there, yeah. So take your first step again. Now, try not to continue to turn your hips out. Turn your eyes that way. Pull the foot right next to your other foot. Stick it out in front. And now push, now when you pushed onto it, you pushed onto your toe, see if you can push your heel. So here's our first step. Just collect this one right underneath. Keep your hips towards me a little bit more.
Where is my feet? My weight is on my left foot.
It's on your right foot.
Right foot.
Yeah.
Okay.
Put your left foot out in front of you. Now we're going to push and drive. So now, when you pushed, you went here. Okay. We're going to just put that foot out, your left foot out again, and we're going to drive straight forward. Uh-huh. Do that one more time. So you're taking your step here. Collect, put your foot out in front of you. So your foot's there ready to take the weight. Uh-huh. And see if you can keep your hand, that's it, mine. Put your foot out in front of you, but don't move your body yet. Just put your foot out in front. Uh-huh. And now go ahead and look this way. Nose and toes are going that way. And I'm going to push. Whoop. When you push, I could feel something changing there. Whoop. I think that time you got a toe. I didn't look down, but just put your heel out. And your back heel, no, you were good where you were. That's it. Your back heel on your right foot is going to start to lift off the floor and push you forward. Uh-huh. Better. You see, there was like a little piece where your foot came up and back down. So if we can keep that kind of lightly skimming across the floor. Let's see if we do it this way. So here's our promenade. Collect that foot, put it the heel out in front. Now push from the back foot. Uh-huh. And there was still a little bit of a bounce.
Okay.
It's just what Elliot was saying, right in between. So we're here, come through, bring the foot, get the foot out in front of you, keep it going. And now, just as smoothly as you can, as if you had a book on your head, we're gonna just smoothly push herself. Yes.
Okay.
That was it.
Okay.
Yeah. Do that again.
Do that again. I better do it one more time.
So take your foot through. So your foot's out there in preparation. And now we're just going to push. Yes.
Yeah. Okay. I think I can do it.
Yeah? Yeah. Whoop. Yeah, how did that feel? Did that feel like she was moving through there better?
Yeah.
It was definitely smoother, right?
Yeah.
Didn't have that bounce in it.
Uh-huh.
But the secret was, it's getting your foot out in front of you so that your body is not moving and then your foot catches it. Your foot's there, and then you just move it, and it actually can skim forward even a little bit more. Yep. And then watch when you take your step that you're not doing, you know, something that's, so it's just nice and smooth across the floor. Uh-huh. And I'll just do it, like, actually I'll hold this hand like we did last time. So you're going to promenade, get your foot out before the body moves. Then push yourself. Mm-hmm. Promenade, get your foot through in front of you. Yep, do you see how I haven't moved until my foot gets there? And and do that one more time. Your left foot's out in front. Yep, and try to keep it as smooth as you can. You got the book on your head. Smooth it out. Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Just bringing, again, awareness to that. You probably didn't even realize it wasn't totally smooth there yet.
Yeah.
One last time, we'll just practice one more time. Let's see how this song is. Let me get you one that has a decent beat here. I think that eventually does, but. Whoop, maybe I need to turn that up. Let me try one other one. There you go. not wait for her. Move out in front, let her come in, fill in the space. That's better. Keep your arm higher on her back. There you go. And go ahead and look the way you're going. That's it. And then look back. Relax the shoulders, lift up the sternum, and don't wait for her, just move out, let her follow you. And notice your arm on her back, that's it. And notice this hand. You see this gap right here?
Yeah.
So ideally, you should always keep this a light connection right here so that never comes apart. But if you over-rotate your body away, turning away from each other, it pulls the hand. So if the hand is open, you know you've rotated too much. Okay. So that's a good little... Yeah? Yeah.
Very good.
Yeah, much better, much smoother.
We got stuff to work on, so...
Yep. Yeah, it's much different.